I think there is an outstanding question that remains to be asked there, and it's around Rory Best. And it's, did they know that Rory Best was going to attend the trial on the Wednesday, on his day off in that week before the France game? And what did they think about his attendance of that trial? I think there are two basic questions that the IRFU still must answer. I'll actually really be interested in Joe Schmidt's answer to those questions as well. I think there's Joe Schmidt is a man who doesn't shy from saying stuff, even at difficult times. For example, this is a totally different thing to the rape trial, obviously, but when there was that incident between Paul O'Connell and Dave Kearney, he had no problem speaking out about Paul O'Connell, despite the fact that Joe Schmidt was just about to take the Ireland job, and that created difficulties here. So he's a man who's has been willing in the past to make public statements. It'd be really interesting to know, did he know that Rory Best was going to go to the trial, and what did he think of it?
Yeah.
And what does he think of it?
Even if they didn't know, right, there's still the question of, should the Ireland rugby captain appear, even in a private capacity, because it's not a private capacity. We know, like, when, I think it might have been Brendan Fanning talking at the weekend, is that, like, you're always on. You're always on as part of your job now. You're always on. So, and then there's also the impact that we now know that the jury were told that he was directed to appear by the defence counsel, which they can't really direct. Like, that's...
But direct was a really interesting choice of words.
And it's made up. Like, it's a made-up thing, you know.
And the way it was explained, it would be very interesting to know exactly what happened here. And it is the question for Rory Best. Why exactly were you there? And I was thinking about this. It's a very difficult thing on one level. If it was somebody in a dressing room for a team that I would have played for, or for someone, you know, would you go in a private capacity to lend support to that person? But it actually doesn't apply to an individual. It's a different thing if you're an international rugby player and you're a captain of an international rugby team. And I think it'd be very interesting to imagine a scenario where that was the captain of the Irish soccer team who had gone to such a trial. What would the outcry have been against that person? I think Rory Best, by the way, was entirely taken aback by the reaction. The way he declined questions on the Friday for the captain's run, the way he spoke on the Saturday. And interestingly, there seems to have been a suggestion from Brendan Kelly, Paddy Jackson's lawyer, that there was a reluctance among certain people who said they were going to give character references at the beginning to give them afterwards. Now, who were those people and what exactly brought about their reluctance?
Yeah, I do think that they're going to have to come out and address this because, rugby is one of those sports that talks about its values a lot, right? To the point where it nauseates a lot of people. And either you talk about it and they mean something, or it's just can't. And if it's just made up marketing bullshit, then fair enough, but you're going to get called on it for the rest of your lives. But if your values mean something, then being the captain is supposed to mean that you are the public representative at all times while you are that Ireland rugby captain, England rugby captain, whatever, while you are that captain. And this is kind of an honorarium then down through the years. Like, you know, you're part of a long line of these people who are supposed to represent the best of that rugby culture. So you therefore, when you show up, represent that rugby culture, and you can't divorce yourself from that if you want to continue in the role, unless you want to not continue in the role, and that's fair enough. Like, that's also fair enough.
I think that's it, and it is this question around the very fact of attendance of himself and Ian Henderson and Craig Gilroy all on the same day in the week where that complainant spoke about going up against the culture of Ulster rugby. Now, it's very interesting when you think about it. You can't describe what happened on that night as a rugby culture. It's deeply unfair for anybody to say that it was a rugby culture on that evening, because it's for two reasons. First of all, there are many rugby people who are utterly appalled by what happened and do not deserve in any way to be associated with it, number one. And number two, to describe it as a rugby culture is to imagine or to contend that it couldn't happen in another sport. which is, of course, a nonsense.
It's happened all around the world in sports, and it's happened in Ireland as well. It's just that
So to describe it as that is not enough. But the problem with the attendance of the Irish rugby captain is that it further identifies Irish rugby with that, with the events of that evening and that trial and everything that happened around it. And that's just it's very difficult to see how that is not the case.
Yeah. So what happens? Do you think that there's like a natural in the summer that maybe Rory Best doesn't go on the tour, or does Rory Best continue as captain and need to just come out and address it? And is there a way that you can address this and still be the Ireland captain? Like, I guess that's the question that we need to see answered. But what do you think?
Well, it was very interesting after the England game. Joe Schmidt played an unbelievably fulsome tribute to Rory Best. And that was, how do you read that? Some people were saying, oh, that means Rory Best is there for the next 18 months and he will lead Ireland into the World Cup. Or was it, and said, listen, I think you're brilliant, but by the way, this is over. And I think it's a moot point. I wouldn't be surprised at all if there's a new Ireland rugby captain after the summer tour.
And like as a direct result of what's happened here, as opposed to because he's not coming to the natural end. It looks like he's just had a really good Six Nations and they're minding him and he's minding himself, because he's obviously at an age now where it's not guaranteed that he's going to make it all the way to the Rugby World Cup. And there was a bit of a plateau in form towards the end of last year, but actually a really strong recovery, played really well in the Six Nations, and looks like he could easily make it to the World Cup now with the way things are going. So you think that if he's not the Ireland captain, it is as a direct result of the fallout from this trial?
I don't know enough about rugby, or I don't know enough about what Joe Schmidt plans and what he intends to do to say that it will be a direct result of that. But I'd say it is a factor within the consideration. It should be said, by the way, that Rory Best comes across as a very decent man, a very likeable man, a very down-to-earth man who seems to be liked by a whole load of other people. But this trial is just everything that it touches. There's a noxious element to it which just it corrodes everything it touches.